The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text number 7, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on March 27th, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Vedadadahi dharmasya Jani Bhavati Bharata Abhutyanam Adharmasya Tadatmanam Sujamaham. This is a very important verse in the Bhagavad Gita. Dharmasya. Dharma is translated into English as religion. And religion is described in the dictionary as a particular type of faith. Actually, it is not that. Dharma does not mean a particular type of faith. Because faith, you may accept some faith, I may accept some faith, another may accept another faith, then there is no question of preaching. Everyone is satisfied with his own particular type of faith, then there is no need of preaching, neither there is need of Krishna's coming, descending on this planet. He said, Yada jadahi dharmasya glani bhavati adharmasya abhuttanam tadatmanam sujamaham. If anyone accepts his own type of religion, so I may not like your religion, you may not like my religion. But everyone is right, then what is the use of Krishna's coming here to rectify adharma? Just try to understand. If everyone's religion is right, I may like or not like, that doesn't matter. You may like my religion. Then there is no question that any religion is irreligion. That's like some religion, they think killing of animals is their religion. And somebody thinks that killing of animals is irreligious. Then which is right, which is wrong? So, dharma does not mean that you manufacture something, I manufacture something at home, or by some assembly, resolution passed. Just like in Western countries, there are so many, here also, by passing resolution, it is accepted as normal. So, Krishna is not speaking of that type of dharma. First of all, you have to understand, jadajadahi dharma saglani. What is dharma? First of all, you have to understand, dharma means occupation and duty, or natural characteristic, that is called dharma. Just like sugar, sugar is sweet. The sweetness is dharma or sugar. Chili is very hot. So the hotness is the dharma of chili. If the chili becomes sweet and sugar becomes hot, that is all. Try to understand. So, first of all, who can give us dharma? That is stated in the Shastra. Dharma to sakshat bhagavat pranitam. Dharma means the orders given by the Supreme Lord or Supreme Being, God. That is dharma. This is the shortest definition of dharma. Dharma to sakshat bhagavat pranitam. Just like law. Law means which is given by the government. You cannot manufacture law at home. That is not possible. I have given this example many times, that in some country the law is keep to the right, in some country keep to the left. I think in America it is keep to the left. In England it is keep to the right. In India keep to the right. Now, which one is correct? Keep to the left or keep to the right? No, according to the government. If the government says that keep to the right is right, then you have to accept that. And the government says keep to the left, that is right, then it is right. We cannot say that in my country I keep to the left, why shall I keep to the right? No, that will not be accepted. Try to understand what is religion. So God is one. God cannot say somewhere that this is religion and this is not religion. God says, Bhagavan Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, here it is said that jada jada hi dharmasya glani bhavati paritranaya sa. The next verse is said, paritranaya sadunam vinasaya cha dushtita dharma sansthapanarthaya cha sambhavani yugedive. Two business, Krishna's, because he has already explained, Bhutanam Ishvara. I am the controller of all living entities. Therefore, when there is discrepancies in execution of dharma, then he is to punish and reward. Puritrana sadhuna vinashayati duskita. Two things. That's why it is the government's duty to give protection to the law-abiding citizen and to punish the outlaw. These two duties of the government. And the supreme government, Krishna, because where from this idea came, the government rewards the law-abiding person or gives protection, and the not law-abiding, there is also protection, but under punishment. So, dharma means, as Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, sarva dharman purityajya mam ekam saranam. This is dharma. This is dharma. And our dharma, our characteristic is also that. Because every one of us, we have surrendered to somebody. Analyze everyone. He has somebody superior where he has surrendered. It may be his family, his wife, or his government, his community, his society, his political party, anywhere. You go, the characteristic is to surrender. That you cannot avoid. That was the talk with Professor Kotovsky in Moscow. I asked him, now you have got your communist philosophy. We have got our Krishna philosophy. Where is the difference in philosophy? You have surrendered to Lenin, and we have surrendered to Krishna. Where is the difference? Everyone has to surrender. It doesn't matter where he is surrendering. If the surrendering is correct, then the things are correct. If the surrendering is not correct, then things are not correct. This is the problem. So, we are surrendering. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has explained this. Jiver Swarup Hoy Nitya Krishna Dar. We are surrendering, but we are not surrendering to Krishna. This is the disease. This is the disease. and Krishna consciousness movement means to cure this disease. Cure this disease. Krishna comes also. He says, Dada Dada in Dharmasya. The Dharmasya glaring discrepancies in the matter of execution religion. When there is discrepancies, Krishna says, Tadātmānam siddhāmaham and abhutthānam adharmasya. Two things are there. When people does not surrender to Krishna, they manufacture so many Krishnas, so many rascals, to surrender there. That is adharmasya. Dharma means to surrender to Krishna. But instead of surrendering to Krishna, they want to surrender to cats, dogs, these, that, so many things. That is adharma. Krishna did not come to establish the so-called Hindu religion or Muslim religion or Christian religion. No. He came to establish real religion. Real religion means we have to submit, surrender to the real person. That is real religion. We are surrendering. Everyone has got some ideas. He has surrendered there. Either political, social, economical, religious, anything. Everyone has got some idea. And the leader of that idea is also there. So our business is to surrender. That is a fact. But we do not know where to surrender. That is evident. And because the surrender is mistaken or misplaced, therefore, the whole world is chaotic condition. We are changing this surrender to that surrender. No more Congress Party. Now Communist Party. Again, no more Communist Party. This party, that party. So what is the use of changing party? Because this party or that party, they are not surrendered to Krishna. So unless you come to the point of surrendering to Krishna, there cannot be any peace. That is the point. Simply by changing from frying pan to the fire will not save you. Therefore, Krishna's last instruction is sarva-dharmān parityajyam māmekam saranam aham tvā sarva pāpebhyam akkhyate. So, the discrepancy of religion means, this is also stated in the Śrīmad-Bhāgavatam, Savai Pungsang Paro Dharma, first class or superior dharma. Paro means superior, transcendental. Savai Pungsang Paro Jato Bhakti Adhokadi. When we surrender to the Adhokhaja, Adhokhaja means the supreme transcendence or Krishna. Krishna's another name is Adhokhaja. Ahoituki apratihata. Ahoituki means without any cause. Without any cause. Not that Krishna is such and such, therefore I surrender. No. Without any cause. Ahoituki apratihata. And it cannot be checked. Nobody can check. If you want to surrender to Krishna, there is no checking. There is no hindrance. You can do it in any position. You can do it. Ahituki apratihata jena atma suprasidati. Then you will atma, your soul, your mind, your body will be satisfied. This is the process. When this thing is discrepancy, there is one verse by a learned scholar, that here we are surrendering to somebody. I am not surrendering to somebody for his satisfaction, but for my satisfaction. I join some political party because I am finding out the opportunity how I can become a minister or how I can capture some power by going through this political party. This is my real end. I do not go to serve the country, maybe one or two. But my real purpose is how to get some opportunity, some position. Therefore, I am not serving that party, but I am serving my ambition. Therefore, service means at the present moment, service means kamadinam kutidhana kutidha palita dunnidesa. Our so-called service is to serve my lust, kamadinam. Kam, krodh, loh, moh, mastajya. We have got all these things. So somebody is serving lust, somebody is serving his anger, somebody is greediness. In this way, we are serving the senses, not the particular person. When you go to the office, we serve. But you do not serve the office, but you serve the money. Because he is paying me, as soon as he says, "No, tomorrow I cannot pay," then namaskar. Therefore, he is serving the money. And why money? Because money will help me in satisfying my senses. Therefore, I am serving my senses. Nobody is serving anyone. Everyone is serving his sense. This is the position. This is dharma sagrani bhavati. As soon as we are engaged in serving our senses, that is dharma sagrani. And as soon as we agree to serve the senses of Krishna, that is dharma. That is the instruction of Bhagavad Gita. When Arjuna was talking with Krishna, in the beginning he was trying to serve his senses. "My dear Krishna, if I kill my relatives, I will entangle in this way of sinful activities, I will go to hell. If I kill my grandfather, the other side, Dronacharya, the other side." No, in this way he concluded, no, I shall not fight. This kind of service is to satisfy Arjuna's own senses. He thought, by killing the other party, I will not be satisfied. I will be very much sorry. That means serving my own senses. Krishna also was giving it in his instruction that you are a kshatriya. It is your duty, and there is no consideration of your relatives or your grandfather or your acharya. When there is opponent, you must fight. That way. In this way they were talking. The talking was that Krishna wanted to satisfy his senses and Arjuna wanted to satisfy his senses. This was going, talking. But Krishna is the Supreme Lord, he is Ishvara. His senses to be satisfied. Then it is service. That is the whole subject matter of Bhagavad Gita. Because Arjuna denied to serve Krishna, Krishna wanted that this battlefield, this Kurukshetra, what is arranged by me, he was simply an instrument, nimitta matra bhavasabhasaj. Even if you do not fight, all these bodies who have assembled, they are not going back, leaving. They will be killed. Now if you like to fight, but the conclusion is already there, because Puritrana sadhunam vinashaya sudhuskita. It was Krishna's plan to kill all these asadhu, duskita, Duryodhana and company. That was his plan. So, that is his business. He came to install Maharaj Yudhishthira, Dharmaraj, on the throne. And he wanted to kill the adharma, Duryodhana and company. That was his business. So therefore this Kurukshetra war was a plan and Arjuna was to help him. Because Arjuna was a devotee, bhaktosi, sakhasiti, because Krishna's friend. Everything is done by Krishna, but Krishna and Arjuna is devotee. And the devotee wants to serve Krishna similarly. Krishna also wants to give credit to his devotee. That is the business between the Lord and his devotee. So, Krishna could do everything. He was competent, everything. But he wanted to give the credit to Arjuna. That was his plan. Krishna has already done everything. But Arjuna, as a common man, he was talking with Krishna. And actually, Arjuna also knew that Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, it is my duty to serve him. This was known to Arjuna. Therefore, he is bhakta. Bhakta means who has dedicated his life to serve Krishna. That is bhakta. Sarvapadhi vinin muktam tatparatena nirmalam rishikena rishikesa sevanam bhakti ruchyat. This is bhakti definition. When one becomes freed from all designation. I am American. This is designation. I am Indian. This is designation. I am Brahmana. This is designation. I am Kshatriya. This is designation. So one has to become free from all designation. This designation is body. I am not this body. I am Brahmasmi. I am spirit soul. Therefore, when one understands that I am not this body, I am spirit soul, I am part and parcel of the Supreme, that is self-realization. Brahma-bhūta, prasannātmā, nasocati nakāṅk, samas-sarveshu-bhūtesu, madhu-bhakti-labhati-panāṁ. This is Brahma-realization. I am Brahmasmi, that I am not this body. So long one is under the conception of this body, he is no better than the animals. Sāyava gokhara. Go means cows and khara means ass. Jasyātu buddhi kunaketi dhāt. For so long we are in the bodily concept of life. We do not know what is our real religion. That is ignorance. Mūḍha. Namāna prabuddhante mūḍha. So long we are in the bodily concept of life. With upādhi designation. So long we are in ignorance. That is dharma sadgran. In ignorance, whatever you do, that has no benefit, either for you or for anyone. So whole thing, whole world is going on under this bodily concept of life designation. I am Indian, I am American, I am this, I am that. So that kind of dharma is not dharma. Therefore Krishna says at this, end of Bhagavad Gita, sarva-dharmān parityajya māmekam śaraṇam braja. This is the Bhagavad Gita religion. It is not Hindu religion or Christian religion or Mohammedan religion. It is the real religion between the soul and God. The reciprocation, the exchange of dealings between the Supreme and the subordinate. That is called bhakti, sarvapadi vininmuktam tatparatena nirmalam. Purified. When you become purified, tatparatena, simply by engaging yourself in the devotional service of the Lord. Cheta tatparamajanam. These are the verdicts of the Shastra. When our heart is cleansed, then we can accept this religion. Sarvadharmān parityajya. This is the religion. To accept Krishna, to surrender to the lotus feet of Krishna. This is religion. So when Krishna says, Jadajadahi dharma sadvani bhavati, when people become averse to God or Krishna, they become godless, they think themselves as God or something like that, that is dharma sadvani. So naturally, here in this material world, every one of us, we have come to enjoy. Material life means enjoy. Enjoyment is not real enjoyment. Real enjoyment is spiritual enjoyment. Spiritual enjoyment, that is with Krishna. That is not in the material world. So, the dharma saklani means when there is discrepancy in the understanding of spiritual identity, that is dharma saklani. Then aham brahmasmi, this is spiritual understanding. When one understands that I am not this body, I am spirit soul, and when he begins, devotional service begins there. That will be explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma. Because we are in darkness, we are not Prasannatma. We are always morose. Although we are serving the country, the community, the family, or anything, but we are not happy, because that is not our relief. When the same service will be converted to the lotus feet of Krishna, then we will be satisfied. Then we will be satisfied. Therefore, one learned scholar has prayed, Kamadinam kutidhana kutidha palita dunnibesa Pisangna karuna jata natrupa nopasanti Sampradam labdha buddhi tamayata nijunkhama matudasi. That I have served so long the calm, crude, moha, masajya, lust, greediness, anger, but they are not satisfied. I have given this example that you cannot satisfy anyone by material service. The example is in our country. Mahatma Gandhi gave his the best capacity, as he understood. He could not satisfy everyone. Somebody killed him. So in this material world, so long we'll be in the material service, either socially or family-wise or community, whatever you do, you'll never be able to satisfy them. They will never say that now you are completely satisfied. Because it is disorganized. It cannot be. But if you try to serve Krishna, a little service will make your life success. Sarvam api asya dharmasya trayate mahato bhaya. Sarvam, very little service. If you give, Krishna is so kind. Sarvam api asya dharmasya. Just like, I'll give you an example. That's like Krishna, when he was a child, the Putana, demon, she wanted to kill Krishna. She did not know that everyone wants to kill Krishna, God, just like Kamsa. He was making plan to kill Krishna as soon as he is born. That is the plan of the demon, to kill God or Krishna, somewhere or other. But actually, Krishna is never killed, he is killed. That is the whole history. So this Putana, she planned that smearing some poison on my breast, I shall allow Krishna to suck it and he'll die. That was his plan. Krishna sucked the poison as well as the Putana's life. She died. But just Krishna's kindness, Krishna thought that seeing this demon, this Rakshasi, she came to kill me by poisoning, but I have sucked her breast, therefore she is my mother. Krishna is so kind. Therefore she must get the position of my mother. So, somewhere or other, if you try to serve Krishna, Krishna is so kind, even if you have gone with a bad purpose, Krishna will accept your service. Krishna is so kind. So why should we serve so many others? And if you serve Krishna, then other service will be automatically done. The society service, the family service, the country service, social service, political service, any service, that will be complete. Why? Because Krishna is the root. Krishna is the root. If you pour water on the root of the tree, the water will approach everywhere in the tree. That is injunction of the Shastra. Yathā taran mūla nisetanena tippanti staskanda bhujopasākha tathā acchuta ijya sarvāhanam acchuta ijya. Because Krishna is the root. Krishna, vijoham sarva-bhūtāna aham ādirhi devāna matta sarmaṁ pravattate iti matta bhajante maṁ bhūdāvāva samannita. So, if you try to serve the root, what at the root, automatically everything will be served. That's like this Krishna consciousness movement. This Krishna consciousness movement is aiming at service, aiming to serve Krishna. That is the only aim. But automatically we are giving social service. Because As soon as one becomes Krishna conscious, he gives us all kinds of intoxication, all kinds of illicit sex, all kinds of meat eating, all kinds of gambling. Is it not social service? Best social service. In America, then the government is appreciating because the people are addicted to LSD and they are seeing practically that as soon as a boy could come to Krishna consciousness, he gives us all this nonsense. They are spending millions of dollars, they cannot stop, but we can stop simply by war. Give up this, and he immediately gives up. So, this is the fact that if you accept this dharma, sarva-dharmān parityajyamāmekam sarva-dharmā, then all the problems of the world will be solved. Therefore, this is needed. And to teach this education, to teach the people, the rascals, therefore Krishna comes, jadā-jadāhi dharma-sangrāni bhavati, tadātmānam sijāmaham. So, Krishna and Krishna's instruction identical. Don't think that Krishna is no longer. He is existing by his word. Take his word. Apply practically in life and you will be happy. That is called Krishna consciousness movement. Thank you very much.